Hello, my dear student of standard 6. How are you? Hope you are fine by the grace of Allah. Today, I am going to start a new chapter, that is chapter 12. And this is summer time, so you must drink more water and take fresh food. Now, I will start your class. Here is some logo. This is the logo of SAARC, ASEAN, and this is the logo of European Union. So you can understand that what will be our chapter's name. So our chapter name is Bangladesh and Regional Corporation. At present, no state alone can meet all its needs. From this necessity, the idea of regional and international cooperation emerged. Example, United Nations was formed with a view to establish world peace. And United Nations, it is an international organization. So, there are different regional organizations such as SAARC, ASEAN, European Union, African Unity, then Organization of Islamic Cooperation, etc. are established with a view to solve different problems among the regional countries. Now, lesson 1 and 2, importance of regional cooperation. What is regional cooperation? Regional or interlocal cooperation simply means one or more units of local government agree to collaborate to provide or share some public service, to operate a public facility, or to plan for their joint futures. Okay. Now, importance. In the modern world, countries are dependent on one another. Problems and needs of different states are different. No state alone can meet all its needs. But if these needs and problems are not solved, welfare and development of the people of the countries is not possible. If the neighboring countries help and cooperate one another, any problem can be solved. For this reason, countries of the same region mutually cooperate one another. As a result, different organizations of regional cooperation are formed. Through collective effort, they work for removing economic, political, and commercial obstacles in this region. Consequently, development of all parties is attained. Now, areas of regional cooperations. At first, commerce and industry, security, energy, transportation and communication, preservation of drugs and smuggling, development and exchange of human resources, culture, sports, tourism, agriculture, health and medicine, climate and environment development, and lastly, information and technology. Okay, that means these are the working area of regional cooperation. Now, this is our main lesson, that is lesson 3 and 4. So, here is one logo of SAARC. You have seen this. So, before starting the main lesson, we will listen the national anthem of SAARC.
Yeah. Comes necklaces pearl of Indian Ocean and island chain of paradise Maldives nation Himalaya crowns her Buddha's late Nepal gold and drawn her across Bangladesh and Bengal from kingdom of Dhruva the last Shangri-La to Afghanistan, the heart and chest of Asia, Lotus Land, India, with an ocean in her name, and holy Pakistan magnifies its fame. In unison, a quarter humankind voice I shall roll. Her voice will reverberate across shore to shore, seeking friendship, peace and cooperation. Holding hands, let's march onward as one.
Thank you for watching the national anthem. Now, SARC. SARC means South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. Who gave the idea of SARC? The idea of SARC was proposed by then Bangladesh ruler Jiaur Rahman in 1979. Why SARC was formed? SARC was formed in 1985 with the intention for enhancing regional cooperation, accelerate growth and promote economic and social development. It was formed by the seven countries of South Asia, which are India, Pakistan, Bhutan, Nepal, Bangladesh, Maldives and Sri Lanka. And Afghanistan joined the SARC as its 8th member state in April 2007. Who is the current or present Secretary General of SARC? Sri Lanka's diplomat Isala Wirakon is the current Secretary General, having assumed charge on 1st March 2020. The official language of SARC is English, and headquarter is the SARC was founded in Dhaka on 8 December 1985, but its secretariat is based in Kathmandu, Nepal. And besides 8 member countries, there are other some observer countries here. So these are Australia, China, Iran, Japan, Mauritius, Myanmar, South Korea and the United States. Now, you will see the flag of different SARC countries. At first, Bangladesh. Then, India, Nepal, This is the flag of Bhutan, Sri Lanka, Pakistan, Maldives, and lastly, Afghanistan. Now, goals and objectives of SAARC. First, to upgrade the lifestyle of the people of SAARC countries. To do free trade among the countries of South Asia. To introduce welfare economic system. To build up self-reliance among the member countries. To work for social and cultural development of the region. To create mutual negotiation among the SAARC countries, removing the existing disputes and problems. Now, ASEAN, that means full form is Association of Southeast Asian Nations. This is the logo of ASEAN, and there are 10 member countries. And member countries are Indonesia, Malaysia, Brunei, Vietnam, Cambodia, Philippines, Laos, Singapore, and Myanmar. And it was established 8 August 1967. Headquarters is situated in Jakarta, Indonesia. Now, goals and objectives of ASEAN. Number one, to work for economic development through collective endeavor, to sustain peace and stability in that region, to work for social, cultural, economic and technological cooperation and amity among the member countries, to organize training and research in professional and vocational fields among themselves, and lastly, to expand cooperation in agriculture and industrial sectors among the member countries. So, up to this today, everyone, you must read properly. Thank you, everyone. Stay at your home safely. Goodbye.